Hello there, crafters of the world. I hope you're having a great day. Today, I would like to take you from a previous project where I showed you how to use your nail varnishes in cards. In this project, as explained briefly in the previous project, I'm going to use soft pastels between the nail varnish areas which were not covered by the nail varnish. So this is something I can control, so I can apply the soft pastels between these areas of nail varnish, which I could not control. As you can see here, the design, I don't know how it's going to get when applying only the nail varnish. And this is what I liked. I decided to further use these soft pastels, and I really like this tray. I got it recently on eBay, 48 colors. I tend to like a very strong colors, so I used mainly pastel blues, pastel greens, some kind of light orange, more like, well, not yellowish. I also used a yellow, I used some kind of purple. So I really like this kind of stuff. Oh, it's so, so great. And you feel so nice, you know, when you start using all the pastels on this card. What you can do with this little card, you can use a die cutting machine and you can cut them in different shapes. You can cut them using your scissors if you want to, or you can use them as bases for some cards and then add flowers, you know, 3D flowers, 3D butterflies, whatever you want. Pardon me. You can also add glitter if you want. I did this on one card, I think. I added some glitter from nail varnish, but you can also add glitter for crafting. So lots of purposes for you can achieve whatever you want to achieve. So it's as simple as that. You only have to use your imagination and the sky is the limit. Of course, with the soft pastels, you always use your fingers. You have to use your fingers to blend them in. So you can see all my fingers are covered in colors. What you see there falling from the cards is nail varnish, which has dried from having covered the cards in nail varnish. So now they dried 24 hours later. And because the nail varnish was not very good quality, also because they tend not to adhere to the card as well, they adhere to the to your nail, that is why they tend to chip. But you know what, is not a major issue. It's not like all the colors from the nail varnish on the card are going to fall. It's only some bits and pieces. So as I said, everyone can do this, and afterwards you can do as you please with these cards, and you can use them in lots of project. I decided to use all my nail varnishes I had in the house that I didn't want to throw away. I have got more like 100 nail varnishes that are still good and are still ready to be used on my nails, but probably they're going to follow the same path in the future if I will decide not to use them. So rather than throw away the nail varnishes, I can use them on cards, as explained in the previous project. You just add nail varnish and water and keep replenishing to cover your cards. Well, that's it. I hope that this was of some inspiration for you today. Keep experimenting and keep in touch with me and have a very nice day. Thank you for watching. Bye.